3, 2, 1.
Hi, sisters. Oh, fuck.
Ew, Tana. Disgusting.
Howdy, sisters. We're back from Coachella weekend one.
We're filming on James's setup today, which means the entire time I'm going to be staring at the viewfinder. And if you don't like that, I'm really sorry.
The quality will be good, so you're also welcome.
See how shitty I look.
These eyelashes are from Coachella, and this is the same blow up from Coachella.
You have not taken off your eyelashes.
Well, I took them off, but like...
I thought you meant you literally have not taken off your eyelashes since it's Coachella.
No, but like, if they would have stayed on, I probably would have just done that. Let's be real. But am I wrong?
Anyways, ladies, welcome back to another video on Tana's channel.
Welcome back.
We're here again.
We're here again.
A little too streaky for me. It's streaky.
We debated on doing this video. I think we didn't know if we wanted to do it. Yeah. But then the people spoke.
They did.
You guys really, really fucking wanted this. I think we realized that we can stay in our lane a little more and maybe focus a little more on reviewing
YouTubers.
Flawless.
As opposed to celebrities.
And Zoe Kravitz.
So for today's video, we are reviewing YouTuber Coachella outfits, which should be fun and fresh. Last year on Tana's channel, we also did this.
Yes.
And it is probably one of my favorite videos, like literally of all time.
Yeah,
and it's for some reason a lot of your guys' favorite videos too.
Yeah, you guys really like when we come for other YouTubers.
So we thought we should do it again. Yeah. But hopefully not be scandalous.
Sister Steam Charles just pointed at my merch. There's absolutely no reason you shouldn't literally click the link in my bio right now and buy it. Please keep these lights on. These ones.
And sister,
And try this again.
Yeah.
This time around, we reviewed...
Me just not even talking. Me literally just letting James do this whole ass intro.
We reviewed celebrity outfits at the Oscars a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
And it got us into quite a scandal.
A sister scandal.
Are we surprised?
Yeah.
No.
You know.
But I will say, as a disclaimer to this video, these are literally just opinions. These are just for fun. A lot of these people we are really, really great friends with. And a lot of these people, even if we are not friends, we do have respect for because we are also in the community. Okay, Tana. I'm trying to get us out of the scandal here.
It's all just in good fun. If you take anything on my channel seriously, like, that's where you went wrong. No offense. Yeah.
Also, we are wearing our own merch almost every single day at this point. We are not fashion critics.
If anyone is like qualified to review fashion.
We do not know what's going on.
Also, our Coachella looks were better than most of your favorite YouTubers. So here we are. I'm so sorry.
You are so stupid. In the wise words of Denzel Dion, I said what I said and I meant what I said. Is that right? What I said and I meant what I said.
We said what we said and what we said is what we said.
No, I don't. Is that right?
I said what I said and what I said was what I said! I had to like say it like him to like make sure.
I said what I said and I said what I said and what I said is what I meant. Or I said what I said and what I...
I don't think meant is in there.
Are you sure?
Yeah,
please. Let's jump right into this.
So we screenshotted only relevant YouTubers. So sorry if your like favorite one that gets no views isn't in here, but now!
I will say before even jumping into this, this year's outfits were a little bit underwhelming.
Yeah. Boring!
Yeah, I feel like last year people really went all out.
Yeah, it was either like Urban Outfitters New Arrivals or like some weird assless chaps. That's like all I saw.
Me. I feel like last year people were really willing to go all out. And like this year I was like, okay, people went all out. I love my looks from last year, but I was like, okay, I'm gonna one-up myself.
Yeah,
literally. One step further.
And everyone else
full
like...
ass out. So I went, woo, way up there, but I feel like everyone else was like, okay, I'm bored, we're gonna tone it down.
Yeah, like Urban Outfitters like, tube top, let's go.
Yeah, so I was like,
yeah.
Oops, a little bit overdressed, but it's okay.
I don't think you were overdressed. I think you were doing what's right. Like, it's fucking Coachella, like, balls to the wall. But we're also very, like that.
We're, people are like, yeah. It's all about the vibes.
And, like, you know, a little lace crop top. Yeah. Get it for them.
I will say, my outfits, love them, was very, very uncomfortable in them the whole time. Absolute worst, I was tucked in all of them.
Oh my god, like, was your dick, like, duct taped?
Oh.
How do you pee?
It doesn't matter. But... like, oh, I was chafing, third day
I was chafing.
Chafing the house, down boots.
My neck's like cut in two from one of my outfits from the
same,
chains. Like,
same, full cut. So I almost wish that I did tone it down a little bit, but at the same time, I'm not sorry. My ass looked amazing, I had a really, really good and fresh time.
Yeah,
so.
Honestly, shout out my big cock boyfriend for carrying me every time my feet hurt and everything was great.
Can't relate.
The dust, you know, from the desert.
So I feel like should we start off by reviewing our own or should we do this last?
See, it's so interesting because I feel like last year I was so much more humble.
I'm like, oh, mine's like an 8.
No, like I'm just gonna give myself a 10 all three now. You know, confidence is up.
Brave.
Regardless if it's actually a 10 on the grand scheme of things, like I left some me. Are you gonna give yourself less than a 10?
Yeah, I would. Well,
I'm being a little bit facetious here and like a little overdramatic. On a real note, I'm just like a doll skill hoe and like anyone can achieve anything I wear. Like,
look at the camera.
I can't.
You need to edit this to not make us look fucking awful.
Okay. Guys, I'm just kidding. Like, people rock. I think we should start with Nikita.
I don't know.
Because she was just like my favorite. Okay. And this yellow chap moment with love this that. Rainbow wig moment. This little Chanel two-piece moment. This one. Oh my God.
Out of all four of her looks, the pink one was by far my favorite. I think that one's a solid 10. Like, wow. So good. The denim Moschino moment is like an 8 for me. Wow. Because I love this. I think it is so beautiful. But she did the same silhouette last year. I like this one a million times better than the green one. Well, maybe not, because I pulled a lot of inspiration from my last year's looks too.
Yeah.
Never mind, I take it back.
The detail in this, like, it fucking sent me. The denim look was my favorite, just cause like the hat. Yeah. Like, are you fucking kidding me? It's just so good. I think the attention to detail, even it saying dragon for me was unexpected. So I wasn't cool. Expecting her to do something like that, like so personalized. The denim look is my favorite. I think the yellow look is my second favorite because it's just, it's really? Not as flashy. She just looks so hot. I like that the yellow doesn't really match the wig. It's very much like, yeah. Offset. The Chanel one I like. I mean, I could definitely see like Sydney Carlson wearing this just like down the street.
The Chanel one isn't my favorite. I think it's a gorgeous look, but I could see her or a lot of other people wearing that.
Anywhere, yeah.
Anywhere.
A lot of stuff's hype. A lot of it's hype.
She was my favorite, like,
Dressed person.
Are you living? I'm living.
Not Coachella, yeah. On Bretman Rock.
Bretman, speaking of Nikita, I was gonna say we should do Bretman next because they did a look together.
Which is so cool, even that within itself, to do like a custom look with your best
friend. With your best friend, so sick.
Who else is doing that? Literally right. No one.
I think they both look so good. Oh my God.
And them wearing Sugar Bear hair backpacks with this that match their look is literally fucking.
Oh, I didn't even notice that.
You know that they were literally walking with the Sugar Bear backpacks. I was like, bitch, Sugar Bear does not deserve that much clout. Like, that's crazy.
Have you done brand deals with them before?
Yeah, they offered me 7 artist passes last year for a post and then they only gave me 4. Now we're in like a little quibble. I think the blonde wig was unexpected too, because she was doing this rainbow wig moment and then just to like.
Oh, she was like hours and hours and hours late to Coachella because she literally was getting her wig switched.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Not really. My like weave was like tangled by this day.
Bretman also had a day 2 look. Really good. I love the pants. I love the crystal top.
I think every IMGA like bedazzled bodysuit hoe is like, this is what they want to look like and they don't. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Sunglasses, the earrings, just everything looks phenomenal.
He is walking Kira Kira. And I really like the fucking, how he did it with like denim. He kind of mixed like the bougie vibes with like textures. I'll just shut up. Textures, yeah.
Next!
Ooh, oh my God. I'm like looking at my camera roll, deciding if I'm ready to like roast people or not. Okay. Should I? Antonio Garza.
Oh, love her.
I love Antonio Garza. But I am so sad. You're rich as fuck. Like, I know your AdSense checks are fucking big. As someone who gets no AdSense, I'm pissed. I feel like it's a very like.
Wait, what does she wear? Let me see. Oh.
Like, I'm on Melrose shopping.
Definitely not my favorite look.
Oh. And I'm just sad, like, Antonio, you're so rich. She's like, I just wanted to have a good time at the festival, like, leave me alone.
I feel like it's important to know that not everybody has to be crazy. Like, it is okay to wear, like, a relatively normal outfit to Coachella.
I know.
Not everybody's us. Chill a little
bit. It's, like, hard for me to, like,
I do like how it's, like, all monochromatic. Like, I like the pink top, the pink pants, the pink eyeshadow, and, like, the pink glasses. I feel like this is definitely, like, a very basic look. Antonio has such an amazing and, like, loud and, like, fun personality.
That you would expect something wild.
I was expecting
something
to a little bit more from her. It's not bad. Yeah. But I just wanted a lot more. Oh, I like that, though.
But this top is on every single girl on Instagram every single day. Like, Alicia Faith was wearing this yesterday to, like, Target. Like, I like the Chanel choker with it.
I don't think that's a real Chanel choker. I like this one. This one's been keeping it simple.
This
like,
one's my favorite.
Yeah, this one's my favorite.
And we're just gonna go barefaced in.
Barefaced, yeah.
It's not crazy, but she does look like an Instagram baddie. And I feel like that's very much the vibe that she tries to go for.
Okay, that's so. Liza Koshy. I can only find
one. Oh, I love this photo of Liza.
This made my cock throb. I feel like everyone was expecting Liza to show up in like a crochet bralette and just call it a day.
Yeah.
And then she fucking did this. She said, goodbye, David. Like, are you kidding me?
This outfit, I think, was so unexpected and so cool. My God.
It is.
The all denim, the cutout in the legs, the crop top, the bralette.
The ponytail, the way
the ponytail.
A little bit different than
normal. The fringe.
The energy. Oh, the fucking energy.
I definitely feel a little moisturizing.
I do too. Like, I feel like a little bit more moisturized.
So, so, so good.
And like the cowboy boots, the look is very custom. Like, it's so trendy. Just like, wow. Like, literally, like, Gigi Hadid sat down for Liza Koshy. I said it.
Did she?
I don't know. Liza was one of my top 10 favorite looks.
This is
Do you remember last
favorite.
Year too? Us just kind of being like, womp, womp.
Not, yes, that's
womp, 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 womp,
womp. I remember Liza was, we were disappointed with her.
Yeah. Dropped her man, got a custom fucking look, raised those arms, called it a day. Should we just like hit all the like dope girls in like one sweep?
Sure.
One sweep of a Doc Martin.
Oh my God.
I love them all. They're all such angels. Let's just start with Ellie Thuman. I love her.
I like Ellie a lot.
One of her looks, this look, sent me. This blue look fucking sent me.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
That's so cute.
She snapped with this. I feel like everyone was really expecting her to keep it super like bohemian and simple. And then she showed up in this like blue latex moment. And, like, I feel like not a lot of people were doing this color or this fucking like material.
I like the color a lot. I think it looks super, super cute. And I love the little bag too.
Her entire group too. Like, everyone's looks, this was my absolute favorite. I think she fucking did that. Little fun buns, like, go off, bitch. Her next look.
Oh, this is not, this is boring.
Yeah, I feel like she like closed her eyes in Urban Outfitters, picked two things and put them on.
Tana! I like how the skirt is asymmetrical and has like the different waistband, but I definitely wish the top was different. It's just a plain black top.
Like, trying to like not be problematic with anything I say. She is so hot, and then she came in really strong with this like blue crazy look that I was kind of expecting her to like follow suit
to keep going
the rest of the weekend. And then I saw this and I was like, okay, I mean, like, she looks great, her body looks great, her hair looks great.
I wish the top was different. It would have really stepped it up for me and hopefully made it equivalent to the previous looks.
Yes, equivalent to the previous looks. Hannah Meloche. She is so fucking hot. They're all so fucking hot.
So pretty. She's beautiful.
Literally, she's absolutely gorgeous.
This, I do like at least this like a little bit better. I like how the top is really small, so like it still looks super cute.
Yeah, and I feel like no one was expecting her to wear like a tiny little top to Coachella because she is very like conservative.
Is she?
Like, even just this little like under boob almost moment, I was like, oh, okay. She's at Coachella.
Work, work.
Yeah.
I like the red glasses matching with the red shorts. I think that's super, super cute.
Yeah, I wish they were, I'll just shut up.
I feel like you have those glasses. What were you about to say?
I wish they were a little tinier. I feel like Coachella is so about like the tiny glasses. Like, Kanye West said it, big glasses are out.
What? Really?
I feel like big glasses are out.
He sent me like a whole email like, you cannot wear big glasses anymore.
It's that's it?
Tiny little glasses.
Kim Kardashian West brought back the small sunglasses trend, but reveals that it was because Kanye said that big sunglasses were out of style.
Especially at Coachella.
Those are not that big.
Yeah, but go smaller.
Small glasses are fucking stupid. You can't even see through that. They're pointless.
Yeah, and then her next look was just very the same kind of vibe, very simple. I think her body looks amazing.
It does.
Like, she goes the fuck
off. Oh, goals.
B-A-W-D-Y, body.
Body mama.
Yeah, you know.
Serving body, yaddy, yaddy.
Okay, I feel like we should keep going with the rest of these dope gals before Emma, though. Every dope girl leading up to their queen, Miss Chamberlain.
Miss Chamberlain.
Olivia. I don't know how to say her last name. It's like me acting like my last name isn't someone smashing their face on a keyboard.
Olivia.
Why don't we just be like Olivia?
Okay, yeah. Oh, I like this!
This is my favorite
look. This is so cool.
I think this is my absolute favorite look out of every single girl in that realm.
So it looks like this was like a...
like a jumpsuit.
A jumpsuit that she just pulled down.
And the pink underneath it. Look at the tiny little glasses. Look at this trendy little bitch with her tiny little fucking glasses. Go the fuck off, you tiny glasses.
I love this look.
10 out of 10.
10 out, this is so, so, so cool. I think Olivia looks so good. I love the pink latex.
And I think like she latex. Like encapsulated like this style and like all of their style really well, but still stepped it up.
And
still
added something.
Very, yeah. Made it very Coachella.
Yeah, yeah.
And I fucking love this.
Yeah.
I literally, my jaw dropped at that. I've seen so many girls in this off-white too. He said, I think we're gonna buy something off-white. There's so many rarer things. Rarer things, Olivia. Yeah. Hated that.
I mean, it's a cute two-piece.
It's very cute. I just think you can spend $700 better.
Fair.
And then her last look was so good too.
Oh, I like that too.
Like, you fucking bitchy ass bitch.
She looks so good.
Tiny little glasses so once again. Good. Tiny little glasses once again.
I like the top a lot.
And I really like how the pants are really big, but the top is really tiny. I think the way they offset each other.
Oh my god, Tana. I do like that silhouette though. Tiny on the top and then big and backy on the bottom. It really gives you that good finger.
And it keeps you like girly, but still like, bitch, I'm here. It's everything.
Let's do Emma. I really like this look from Emma. Did you not?
I liked her other look far more. I think this was really, really expected.
Well, I feel like Emma is a little bit more modest in the clothes that she picks. Like, she doesn't really wear, like, bras.
Oh, I guess that's true. And this is a good, like, yitty moment.
Her boobs look phenomenal. She looks good and also simultaneously fresh. The smaller red glasses. She went smaller just for you, Tana.
Because she's fucking trendy.
I like the pants, too. I feel like the pants are very Emma.
This look was my favorite.
Oh, I like this. I do like this one more.
These pants on the bottom of them having the pink fluff.
Yeah.
And then her putting the pink little things in her hair fucking sent me.
So good.
Fucking sent me.
I really like this look from Emma a lot. I think this was so cool. Still very her.
And the pants are just dope as fuck.
Yeah.
I feel like these pants are so cool. Like every bitch was like, where did you get your pants?
A million people probably asked her where she got this from.
Like the pink fur on the bottom fucking sent my ass. That look was a 10 for me. That's... Imagine like a butterfly wing.
No, let's not imagine a butterfly wing. No. Oh, we can't talk about him.
Really?
I don't want to get in a scandal.
What if I just cover your face while I say that Manny MUA could have dressed so much better?
It's not my favorite look, that's for sure.
Boohoo Man Clearance.
Is that where it's from?
No, it's just serving me Boohoo Man Clearance.
Oh, okay.
I feel like Manny is the type of person too to like not be shy to like be like, bitch, I have money.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention. Sorry.
Madison Beer.
Ooh, I like this.
She had three looks and...
Oh my God.
One was just kind of like shorts, like a bralette, little jacket moment.
Oh, I have that jacket.
Yeah, it's a good jacket.
It is a good jacket. Mm-hmm.
But I think she made up for it with this one.
Yeah, that's actually really, really cool.
This goes the fuck off. She's so hot though. She could literally wear fucking two sugar packets and some dental floss and I'd be like, like straight up. Bitch goes off. If I was perfect, like I would show up to Coachella in a onesie.
Like, can you imagine having like a good enough body and like just being pretty enough to like show up like that?
Yeah, literally. If I was her, I would show up in a goddamn Care Bear onesie. Jake and Logan Paul.
Oh.
Oh!
Logan's outfit I hate. Jake's outfit I actually don't mind.
I think Jake did a really good job. I really like the glasses. I think they're really trendy.
The visor.
Sure. No, but they were glasses. He was wearing them like as glasses.
It's a visor.
Okay.
Miss Mojo.
I really like Jake's outfit. I wish he would shave his chest though.
Why?
I don't know. Just wouldn't you expect Jake Paul to have a shaved chest?
I would.
Yeah.
I like this a lot. Like, I feel like it's so easy for a guy to show up at Coachella with like denim pants on and a button up and look stupid.
Yeah, literally.
But like, this is a really, really cool look.
The shoes are fucking cool as shit too. They're like big ass, like white.
I wouldn't expect Jake Paul to wear those type of shoes. I really like them actually.
I love his look. I think Logan looks coked out.
Oh my God.
Love you, Logan. Stay impulsive as fuck, you know, but. I feel like he looks like guys I like fucked in high school and like what they wear to Coachella now. I was waiting for like an okay.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna call next.
Like, love TikTok.
Turn off
opening.
Your fucking TikTok notification.
I'm sorry, I'm a TikTok star now.
Are you?
No.
Scared.
Billy. So this next look from Billy, I am utterly obsessed with. I wish I could pull this off.
Okay, so personally, I would never wear this. I just think it's so her. It's like so crazy. Like I do like it. Stop.
She's like, it's not wearing makeup.
Her Coachella set was so dope. I love watching. Shut up, you're not even annoying. Felt like I was just like having a party with
her. She literally handled Coachella like it was like her 15th Coachella.
But I think the whole point of these videos is that we're supposed to be able to see where they were coming from their style.
Yeah. Dude, like bury me in this outfit when I die. It's perfect. Wolfie Cindy. She had a few looks.
Oh. I didn't even recognize her with the pink hair.
The wig looks so synthetic though. I don't hate it. I saw a lot of girls in this outfit and like you are literally Wolfie Cindy. Like Justin Bieber grid posted your face once looking for you. Let's not forget that.
Did he?
Yeah, that's how she became famous. He literally grid posted a photo of her and was like, who is this girl? Someone find her. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Also, did you say grid post? That's kind of a good term for it. I never know what to call it, like feed post, main
grid.
Static grid. Static post. Static post. Not my favorite, but I do appreciate the fact that she went all out with the colorful.
I'm gonna give her the benefit of the doubt and hope this was like a Boohoo brand deal and she had to wear this. Then again, the next few days, she really like this is so cute, this like Dior bandana.
Oh, that is good. I like that skirt a lot and the Dior bandana is kind of good, kind of fresh.
I love that David made all of his fucking minions, that he gave all of his fucking minions clout to.
The vlog squad.
I'm kidding. I'm absolutely kidding. I think it looked so cool.
Did they actually wear it to the festival?
I don't know if they wore it to the festival.
I don't think they did.
But they all posted like a fuck ton of content in it, like the matching bandanas.
Yeah, it looked super, super cool.
I think it was a statement. It's really nice that they let Dirty Dom in on it. You know, they really let everyone in on it.
I truly do love everyone in the vlog squad. Like,
you're like a Jeff.
I made it into the vlog with my butt. Of course, my daddy, Jeff. I just love all of them. So it was really cool to see like all the vlog squad merch. Obviously, it's not like a fashion item.
No, I think it was like we have more clout than everyone statement, you know?
Fair. I was just like how all my friends were like, we all wear sisters merch all the time. Kind of the same thing. Like, it just feels really cool when your friends like supporting you and your brand. Like,
yeah, exactly.
It's a really cool thing.
I'm like, and they all probably had artist wristbands under that from David, so it's the least they can do.
Who's this?
Jordan Woods.
Oh.
Okay, the Dolan twins. I'm like, I don't know if you've heard of them or anything.
I haven't.
Just like, they're just like these twins like on YouTube, yeah.
First of all, they filmed a video where they each picked out each other's Coachella outfits a few days prior. As soon as they saw my feed, I was like, brave. I would never let anybody pick out my outfits.
Yeah,
that's
literally
horrifying. Ethan fucked up Grayson's outfit on purpose. Grayson was not happy about it. I like both of these looks a lot, actually. Ethan's pants look so chic, actually.
Yeah.
And I love the tops, too.
They said abs. Like, literally, they just said abs.
Yeah,
and the pants are so
dope. It's a similar pattern shirt, but, like, different colors. So it's like,
yeah,
we're twins, but we have our separate brands.
Yeah. But I don't even want to talk about this fucking, this outfit anymore. I want to move on to their second outfit. Because it was fucking everything.
Oh, yeah.
This spoke volumes. This was it. Every single like YouTube influencer guy, whatever, like, they sat down to this.
Yeah,
like
the Louis pants look so cool on Ethan. I love that he went with the
choke me with those pants.
The Louis pants look so cool on Ethan. I love the pattern. I love that he went with the white tank top to match. The Louis harness is so, so, so sick. You can only get the blue on a custom order, so that's really cool too. I do wish Grayson didn't have a tank top underneath this.
And yeah, if it was like shirtless or like an all blue moment.
No, I feel like abs out, it still looks really, really good.
I think it's fucking perfect, and I give them a 10 for this look. My jaw was on the floor at this photo. Austin McBroom and Catherine. I love them, but I was not expecting her to show up to Coachella in like her shirt.
Well, I was not expecting them to show up to Coachella, period.
Okay, like, T. Yeah, like, who's babysitting?
I will say it's definitely, it's just pants and a shirt and then like a shirt and biker shorts.
And I feel like their whole mantra is like, hey, we're attractive and rich and we have kids. So like, I was not expecting this PacSun moment.
Yeah.
Not even necessarily that I was expecting them to be like flaunting their money. I was just expecting her to be in something like
hot,
crazy, sexy.
Catherine has a
her body.
Beautiful body. She's been sending me Snapchat updates.
Yeah, she's been
like
on her Instagram story.
I do wish she wore something more showy.
Yeah.
Like a little bit just more amped up.
I like, even like if the biker shorts like bedazzled and the top was like little. Let me show you Paris Hilton really quick because I'm just,
oh my gosh. I love her so much.
She's my favorite person on earth, but like, why does this keep happening?
It's not my favorite look.
It's so funny because everything she wears is always so bougie, but it's just like,
it's Balmain.
And like the glasses being Gucci. Like, it's an expensive ass look, but like, you could have dressed better at like Topshop. Oh my God. And I worship her. I would literally suck the fart out of her asshole.
Ew, I DM'd her this weekend. I was like, I wanna see you, sister.
I know, I was like looking for her. Literally, she's so sweet too. I feel like she really loves like influencers.
Well, she's the OG influencer.
Exactly, literally. She like invented the selfie.
She did.
So why the fuck are you in fucking bedazzled cat ears? I'm gonna stop. Lele.
Miss Lele Fon.
Hola, mi amo Lele.
I actually like this look.
I think her looks went off. She did another like butterfly wing moment and it was so fucking cute. This top, I feel like style is very trendy right now.
Yeah, I will say no matter what she does or wherever she's going, she goes full out.
Which
like
I
she
love.
She said, I'm an Instagram queen. I'm the most followed influencer and I will be there.
Yeah.
Influencer.
She said, love all 29.4 million of my followers.
I think she's 34 million now.
I mean, Maddie Ziegler tied a fucking Dior scarf around her tits, but I feel like it really just like
she looks good though.
Yeah,
that's good.
Yeah, but imagine like a flowy matching pant.
Ooh.
Imagine
so
a Dior
cool
bucket hat. I just keep going.
I personally do not like bucket hats.
Oh my god, Kylie's Dior bucket hat. I feel like very quickly, I just want to touch on Kylie's look was probably one of my favorite looks of Coachella.
I like this a lot.
And the fact that no one even saw her. Yeah. She was like barely photographed. Like, it's so good.
I wonder where like that where the set is from.
I'm like, let me check Kylie Jenner outfits. It's my number one suggested Instagram that I search every day.
Oh, should we check Kylie's closet?
Everything she does, every hoe follows suit. And it is just, she's the president of these hoes, and I love it.
She really is. Queen of trendsetting, honestly.
She could literally do anything. She could wear a tablecloth, and I would wear a tablecloth the next day.
I think her man's honestly looks pretty decent, too.
Like, literally tag team me. Brad Sousa has left the chat. Jordan Woods.
I'll take Brad.
Let's just, you know, we talked about Kylie. Let's end this with Jordan.
This is not my favorite look.
She is so hot. And then to show up to Coachella like this let me down. When I worked at PacSun, this is how I dressed.
You worked at PacSun?
Yeah.
Did you really?
Yeah.
I did too.
This is not, this is very, very, very boring.
And just the worst, like if you're gonna be boring, at least do better. Sorry.
Okay.
I saw this and like shat myself. And I feel like right now she's in this phase where she needs to be like, look, I'm my own person and I'm like so cute, like without Kylie. Yeah. Like,
I think all eyes are on her right now, obviously, like see where she's going, especially like what she's doing.
Yeah.
So I feel like if that were me, well, I wouldn't want it to be me. I would never do that. If you're gonna get into a, well, I mean like we know firsthand, if you're gonna get into a scandal.
Dress cute after.
If you're gonna get into a scandal, first of all, apologize and own it. But then use that time wisely.
I get why she was hiding. I feel like this is the only photo I saw of her at all. And like, if I was wearing that, like I would do the same thing.
Oh my God.
This video's over.
All right, guys.
I had a booger in my nose top.
All right, sisters. That was it for this year's YouTuber slash a little bit of celebrity Coachella outfits review. We tried to be nicer. We wanted to have a little less of a scandal.
I tried to be nicer. I feel like this is literally just for fun. It's our
my life
personal
is an
opinion.
Outfit
is same, honestly. Yeah. Can't relate. It's all fun and games. Even if we didn't like an outfit, somebody else may. And that is totally okay. And yeah. Regardless.
Like, I'm sure Jordan Wood's team told her that was
tough. Tight.
Stay scandalous, sisters. Thank you so much for checking your Instagram, James.
You're welcome, Tana Mongeau.
Thank you so much for watching, and we'll talk to you guys very soon. Bye.
That's it. No thumbs up, subscribe, social media.
Tweet me at David Dobrik.
Nothing?
We can do that if you want. That's why I'm okay. Less relevant
Bye.
Than you.
Look at how my site profile looks.
Okay.
I'm famous.